Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Mirabel Family TV. Please, if you are seeing our channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like our video, share and also comment. And may God bless you as you do that. If you are subscribed to us before, thank you. Those that are supporting us, we say thank you. For those that are watching our videos, thank you all. May God bless you all in Jesus' name. Today's video, I want to be talking to the mothers in the house or the mothers in the old world, and this topic is especially to our female children. How close are we to our female children? What relationship do you have with your female child? You know, female children, they are supposed to be very close to their mothers, but because of work, because of war, because of career, because of something, one thing or the other, we are not close to them. We call ourselves mothers, but we are like visitors to our children. We don't have time for them. When in the morning, our own is just to dress and go to work. In the evening, we come back, we are very tired, we cook for them, we eat. Fine, we know that all mothers care for their children. We buy them what they want. We give them money. We buy them clothes. We buy them expensive clothes. But this time around, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about your relationship with your female children. Your relationship with your female child matters a lot. When you are close to them, they will tell you everything. They will always open up to you. But when you are very far from them, they will be afraid to come close to you. They will be afraid to talk to you. Maybe there will be something that is bothering them. Maybe there is something that someone did to them that wasn't right, that wasn't good. Because you are not there for them, because you are not close to them, because you don't ask them questions, they will not tell you. Sometimes some things will happen and some mothers will start crying that my daughter did not tell me that this thing was going on. She didn't tell me anything about it, because you don't ask her questions. You don't notice her. You don't see changes in her. Mostly the female ones. I'm talking about the female children now. Let us be close to them. As a mother, we are supposed to be very close to them. Even if you wasn't close to them at their earlier age. But I think as from a certain age, like 10, 11, we have to be close to them. We have to lecture them on so many things. Some children, they don't even know anything like their monthly, this thing. You know what I'm talking about, the female ones now. You as a mother, you have to lecture that child before that stage. You know, Europe children now, as from 11 years, some 10 years, that monthly cycle will start. How are you lecturing them before that time? We have to lecture them about so many things before it happens. That's why you see some children, the thing will start, they will not tell their parents. Because why? Their mother haven't told them that there's something like that. They prefer to tell their friends. They prefer to tell other people than their own mother, because their mothers don't have time. Let us try as much as possible to be close to our female children. There are so many things that we need to tell them. There are so many things that they need to know as well. Some mothers, they don't even have time for their own children. All they know is work. They can take like 2 hours to sit down, to take care of themselves, to dress up, to make up. They cannot take 10 minutes or 20 minutes to ask their children questions. We need to ask our children questions. We need to relate with our children. What is your relationship? What is your relationship with your own children? What do they know you as? Do they know you just like my mother? No, it's more than that. We are more than that. You understand? We have to be close to our female children so that when anything is going wrong, we will be the first to know. Instead of outsider, there are some mothers self. Something will be happening to their children. Their body system, everything will be changing. It's outsider that will be telling them that, don't you notice something in your child? Can't you see that she's changing? Can't you see that something is changing in her? Can't you see that her way is changing? Her attitude is changing? The mother will say, no, I didn't notice anything. You know why she didn't notice? Because she don't have time for that child. Because she don't have time. All she knows is to go to work. Come on. Work is good. Fine. We need to work. Yeah, we need to work. It's very important to work. But our children should be our priority. Some people, they don't even know the schedule of their children in schools. Some people, they don't even have time to even take their children out. They don't have time for that. All they just know is money, 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 money. Money is not everything. Money is not everything. Sometimes when I hear some stories about female children, I didn't know that this one was doing this to my child, to my daughter, and now my daughter didn't tell me. The thing was going on for like some years. I didn't know, and now I just knew he wanted to spoil my daughter's life for me, because you weren't there for that your daughter. If you were there for her, I bet you she would tell you. Let us be close to our female children. So many things are happening in the world now. Do you know that some people can drop their children anywhere just because of work? Sometimes when there's a strike in the school, when there is there's anything in the school, they say the children should not come to school. So mothers, they can drop their children anywhere. Go to Mr. A house, go to Mr. B house, go to Mrs. Nene house. They will call this one. How can you look at my children for me? They call this one. Haven't you heard of so many things that is happening? Some people are wicked. Some people, they are at, they are evil. They don't wish good things to others' children. Be careful who you leave your child for. Be careful who you take your children to. What relationship do you have with your female child? What relationship do you have with your daughter? Some people will tell you that my daughter, she don't even know how to sweep. She don't even know how to do this. Because you didn't teach her, don't blame her. I don't blame those children. Me, I don't blame any child that don't know how to do anything. If you don't teach her, if you don't tell her you have to sweep, she won't know. Especially these Europe children. These Europe children, if you don't teach them things, they will just neglect it. They will think that it's not important. We need to be close to them. We need to take them close to us. We need to take them to the kitchen when we are cooking. We need to ask them questions. We need to know what is going on in their life, their day-to-day activities. We need to be close to our children. Let's be close to them. Let's be close to our female children. Let's lecture our female children. Let's teach them. Let's tell them. There are so many things we need to tell them, of which I can't mention here. You know, as a woman, as a mother that you are, you know every stages of a woman. You know all the things that occurs in the life of women. You know what happens in the life of a woman if the woman is not careful. We need to look for a way to explain it to them. We need to look for a language to use to put those things into their brain. We need to let our daughters to know that they should be careful. They should be careful. We need to explain to them. As a mother, you know what I'm talking about. I don't just want to mention everything like that. We need to lecture our children on so many things. How close are you to your children? What is your relationship to your female children, even the male children? Let's relate with them. Let's relate to our female children. Let's talk to them. Teach them some things that they ought to know. Lecture them. There are so many things that the female children ought to know. Let's lecture them before that time. Let's tell them. Some things will happen in their schools. They can't tell you. Because when they are even coming, some mothers, when their children are coming, no. Go to sleep. I don't have time. I'm late to work. I'm tired. I want to sleep. I'll go to work tomorrow morning. Mm-mm. That child, you are killing that child's spirit. You are pushing that child away from you. Leave that child, that particular, if you are tired, maybe later when you have rested, go and meet that child. Ask him or her, what did you want to tell me? You have anything to tell me? Do you want to tell me something? When you see that your child is a bit dull, she's not like as usual, or your son, draw that child closer. Ask him or her question. There might be something that is bothering him or her. Sometimes some of my children, I'll just notice that this child is not happy. I'll call him or I'll call her. I'll ask him or her, what is wrong? Is there anything you want to tell me? Sometimes he will not like to tell me at first, but I will insist. There's a way we need to talk to our children. Even if they are hiding anything from us, they will tell us. Let us be our children's best friend. Let us encourage our children in their academics. Let us encourage them. Let us always Above all, let us always pray for our children. It's very necessary. Let us declare good things in the life of our children. Let us always speak positivities into the lives of our children. It's very necessary. Let us speak positivities into their lives. Let us always wish them good. Let us wish them well in everything they do. Our prayers matter a lot in the life of our children. Our words matter a lot. Let us try to speak those good words, those positive words to the life of our children. Let us encourage them in their studies. Some children don't do well in their studies. They need your encouragement. Do encourage them. They need you, even if you can't teach them, but they need you to tell them that, you did well. You did great. This is good. The one that is not good, this one was not very good, but I know you can do better. Try to do better next time. That is it. You have given that child the spirit to move on. When that child fails in one thing, tell that child that, no, you can make it. You will make it. Try to encourage them. Try to check on them. Try to ask them questions. Try to bring them closer to yourself. You will see that they will like to always talk to you. Even when you are in your sad mood, they will come and ask you, Mommy, are you okay? Mommy, are you fine? Mommy, what is it? Mommy, are you crying? The children are like that. When I'm sad, my children notice. When I'm not happy, my children notice. Because they know, they always know when I'm happy. They will always notice. That is the same way we are supposed to notice our children. Let us teach our children so many things they ought to know. Let us lecture the female children on the tasks ahead of them. Those ones that have not started their monthly circles, let us tell them down. Let us try to lecture them down. It might happen outside the house. It might happen in their school. But when you have already told that child that this thing will happen anytime, this thing can come anytime, the child, when it will come, it will not look surprised to that child. You already know what to do. Tell that child, when this thing starts, when it comes like this, this is what you ought to do. If you are in the house, fine. But if you are in the school or you are outside, you notice this thing, this is what you need to do. You will see, that child will know it. When you don't tell her, when the thing will start, some children will even be crying because they haven't seen it before. I've heard that some children, they cried when their monthly cycle starts. Because they haven't heard it before. They haven't seen it before. So it's a surprise to them. So as a mother, we need to have a good relationship with our children. We need to lecture our children on so many things. We need to tell our children so many things. We need to draw them closer. We need to ask them questions. We need to ask them how their day went. We shouldn't put work as priority. We shouldn't put our career as priority. We shouldn't put our work, our business as priority. Let our children be our priority. What is your relationship with your children? All right, this is the end of today's video. Thank you all for watching. May God bless you all. Don't forget to like our videos, subscribe, and share. May God bless you all. See you in our next video. Bye-bye.